New York artist Guy Stanley Filoche says his series Give Us Our Flowers celebrates African-American culture.
As a kid, I used to go to museums all the time, and I used to always see portraits of white people, you know? And there was never portraits of black and brown people, portraits that look like me. So I decided to honor us.
Filoche is one of the artists representing black creators at the LA Art Show. In Playtime, Gregory Saint-Amand explores self-perceptions of children of color growing up in America.
The idea also of the colors balancing against the black and white portraiture. My thing is, like, you walk into a room, nobody knows who you are, they perceive you a certain way, but once you open your mouth, that, you know, shows your personality, and that becomes your armor against society. You know, you're not just one of them, but you're this person. So all my work kind of plays with that.
Jamaican-born O'Neill Scott reflects on childhood memories of immigrating to the United States and finding his way in a new country.
Just as an African-American, I think it's important to be able to really cautiously understand how you're going to go about navigating the world. It's just one of those things that that I think we constantly think about. It's constantly in the back of our minds, how we're perceived, stuff like that.
Artist Ceron Green says black Americans experience both invisibility and hypervisibility.
Me, my personal experience is more of a hypervisible, because the world's been taught that I'm dangerous because I'm a black man. As far as being invisible, I really don't get that too much. Like, but it could be something as simple as being in a Starbucks and trying to get somebody to wait on you, or, you know, they act like they don't see you.
Brooklyn-based gallery owner Tanya Wiedemeyer, who organized these artists and helped showcase their work in Los Angeles, says black representation in arts uplifts the entire community.
Whenever someone steps into the booth or steps into the gallery or steps into the museum and see themselves in that particular portrait, it makes people feel good. It makes people feel that they're being recognized. And so this is where the Renaissance is happening, because I can simply identify with that person that's in that image.
And these New York-based artists are hoping to carry on the message to future generations as they visit a local after-school program to help students create their own portraits. Jenya Dulo, VOA News, Los Angeles.